120 BPM is a film set in the early 1990s when the AIDS crisis in Paris was still very fraught and very tense. It is a deeply moving film on a deeply moving subject, and how important is it for people to watch a film like this today?
I think it's true what we were just saying just before we start filming. The memory of those times has faded for a lot of people, even the ones who lived through it. And for the people who came after, and there's loads of them now on the scene, it's very second hand, all that kind of stuff, and it's not actually talked about an awful lot. I mean, it's in the collective consciousness, but the sharpness of it really isn't dwelt on. And I think the impact of this movie is one thing that I really celebrate, and it's one reason why people should watch it.
And I think for the kind of queer generation that I'm part of, they're isn't much knowledge of what happened during those times and how politicized our queer identity was during during those years, and a film that really shows the legacy of ACT UP and the desperation and passion of those who fought with them is so important for a generation that might not be familiar with that.
And of course, whilst everything in this country is so much better than it was, certainly much better than the early 1990s, there's still an AIDS crisis in the rest of the world. I mean, this film surely will be an important marker for other communities around the globe.
Absolutely, yes. I mean, I think the culture within the gay world has changed a lot, the attitude, but there is still, I won't say it's a crisis in the same way, but there are still worrying things going on within the gay world. And in this country, let alone the rest of the world, there are pockets of populations that are still not being contacted by the medications, and I think that's a big worry.
I think there's still a real need for activism. I mean, you're absolutely right in what you say about the world situation, but if you just look at the UK, if we learn nothing new, if we have no new developments at all, we still have the capability to stop all transmission of HIV in the UK. We know how to do it, and we know that we're capable of doing it, and yet there are still people who are who are acquiring infection with HIV, and that's entirely preventable.
Is the government investing enough money in making it possible for doctors in your position to help reach that situation?
Well, clearly not. So it's not possible to prescribe PrEP, pre-exposure prophylaxis, under the NHS, outside of clinical studies. There is not nearly enough availability of PrEP to meet demand. There's a big problem with diagnosing people with HIV. There is not nearly enough testing going on, and resources for sexual health are being reduced. I mean, in Brighton, where we are at the moment, there will be a 20% cut in funding for sexual health in general, and that's going to affect our ability to do more HIV testing. We need to be doing more, and we're likely to have to do less. I think it's really important that we do look back, because there's lots to learn from what happened before.